families. Maybe we could start by listening to women. Culture change happens from both the top down, for example policy, and the bottom up, with people's experiences. Families have been set up as peer support, with women using their own experiences and sharing achievements. Mothers supporting mothers, helping to build a more supportive culture. Families need seamless policies and programmes in place to provide support whenever needed on mothers' breastfeeding journey. Otherwise, they can fall through gaps in services. Following birth, good support in the community from health professionals, plus access to peer supporters and drop-in groups in children's centres are vital. Perhaps the smartest way forward, in addition to implementing better national policy and education around breastfeeding, is simply to listen and learn.
Congratulations, congratulations, Councillor. You'll not go far wrong if you stick to the point of the motion. Do your research and speak clearly. Very well done indeed. Some people are very brave, Councillor Small.
First of all, just congratulate Councillor McIntyre for that really powerful speech in Councillor Didsbury for bringing this forward. I wanted to speak on this because I've been privileged to work with Liverpool Community Bambis quite a lot over the last 2 years since I've been doing this role in education. And I think we should be very proud as a city of the work that goes on with Liverpool Community Bambis in our network of Short Start Children's Centres. I wanted just to raise one or two issues and to highlight one or two things that Liverpool Community Bambis is doing quite innovatively, I think with quite a wide ranging implications on public sector delivery. The first one is around the peer supporters, which Councillor Didsbury raised earlier. This is about mums supporting other mums. It's about getting better health outcomes, increasing the prevalence of breastfeeding. But it's also about supporting mums to acquire new skills, supporting mums to get those new skills and to return into work. Bambis also supports a Facebook group moderated by the Children's Centre, but with lots of peer-to-peer support. And there's over 5,000 mums who are part of that Facebook group. But what that offers is 24/7 real-time support where mums can support each other. And it's quite an innovative use of social media to do that, and it has a big impact and it's very effective. The third thing I wanted to mention was the work that Bambis have done to support challenging some of those cultural attitudes around breastfeeding and also increasing breastfeeding awareness. Earlier this month, Bambis supported the National Breastfeeding Awareness Week with events across the city at St George's Hall, a family picnic at Liverpool One, working with businesses to encourage them to become breastfeeding friendly, with quite a lot of success, and it's something that I think we all should be very proud of. But some of those attitudes and some of the things that we heard from Councillor Makinson, I think they're completely wrong, and this is why we need Bambis to be challenging some of those outdated attitudes. And I've got a message for Councillor Makinson. It's not women who are breastfeeding, it's not mums who are in the 1950s, it's your outdated sexist attitudes. And I invite Councillor Makinson to stand up here tonight and publicly apologise for the disgraceful views that you expressed to a new mum on social media. They were wrong, you read the comments, stand up tonight and apologise to this council.
So they wishes to take.
I'll just accept.
issues in the motion as well.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. I was really lucky enough to go to the National Breastfeeding Celebration event on St George's Plateau, and it was fantastic to see lots of new mums and some dads as well, supporting their partners who choose to breastfeed, and it was fantastic. And these, for anyone that hasn't seen them, are the lovely groups that the Children's Centres use to teach those who want to make that decision.
To be criticised, ostracised, or made to feel excited the idea of a quality catalogue for businesses in the city of Breastfeeding. I had my daughter 14 years ago, and I fully support a woman's right to choose how she feeds her baby. I chose Breastfeeding. My professional background had been fostering children. I thought having my own child was going to be an absolute breeze. She didn't come with baggage, she was coming into a home where she was loved, and I thought it was going to be easy. 6 weeks later, when I'd had no sleep, I was covered in poo, I was covered in vomit. I actually thought that this was when I could give back to social services, like one of my foster children. And at 3 a.m, my husband said, "Love, she's ours." And I remember feeling absolutely exhausted. We had to go and do the shopping in one of our local supermarkets. And we're walking around and I'm knackered, and Nige very kindly says to me, "Should we go and have something to eat in the cafe?" So we went into the supermarket cafe and we sat in the corner because I didn't want people looking at me. I don't think I washed my hair for about 3 weeks. I was covered in baby sick. And I was sitting in the corner having sausage and chips or something, completely unhealthy because the carbs, the desire for carbs was huge. And Alana started to cry, as she did regularly, for months. I decided to feed her. I was sitting in the corner of the cafe. Nigel was opposite me, I put the trolley next to me, started to feed her, completely covered up. And a member of staff approached after about 2 minutes.